Brandon from eBoat Loans.
Hi, this is Jamie.
It's October 22nd, 2008, and we just wanted to talk to you a little bit about what's going on in the marine industry right now, and as far as boat loans or marine financing. Everybody's still wondering, are you still lending on boat loans? They may have heard a few banks have dropped out, but there are still quite a few banks that are out there lending, and they're out there lending for good credit. So is it still available? Absolutely. However, there are a few items that have changed.
For example, on stated income, it's a much more limited market right now. It is still possible to get a stated income loan done where tax returns aren't required or proof of income isn't required, but really there's only a couple of lenders out there that still offer this program, and it's really on an exception basis.
So let's talk about who it may apply to. So somebody that's been with GE for 20 years, that'll apply to them. If they've been with the Bank of America for 5 to 10 years, that's a good bank that's still out there, that's still available.
And they're full-time employed.
So now places where it may not be available and where we're finding a little bit stricter policy is people in real estate, people in construction, self-employed people.
Correct.
So they're going to want to see some verification of income. So, you know, where we said those no-doc programs that used to be available are most likely not going to happen anymore. So again, it's an exception basis, but the industry has changed. It's a little bit like the mortgage industry. So, you know, you're not going to see too many interest-only programs available anymore.
Right.
So is there anything else you can think of that may not apply?
Well, from a down payment standpoint, just to touch on stated income for a moment, it used to be that if the down payment was significant, 20 or 25%, that kind of paved the way for a stated income approval. And we get asked quite a bit, if I put 20, 25, 30% down, can we then go stated income? And again, it's really not a function of down payment anymore. It's more a function of the deal in its entirety. So for relatively small loans, let's say $250,000 or less, it is possible on a stated income basis. But for everyone looking at a boat loan greater than $250,000, the game really remains the same, because it's always somewhat been that way. We need a full financial package, tax returns, a personal financial statement, business tax returns if that applies. So from a down payment perspective, there's really not much change on the required down payment above 250. And below 250, the zero down and the 10% down programs are also not as available as they have been in the past.
So where you might find some of those lower down payments might be some manufacturer incentives. So if you're going to a boat show, you might find a zero down, you might find a 10% down, you might find a great rate where a manufacturer is trying to get rid of some inventory. So great boats, you know, they're still great buys. The Fort Lauderdale Boat Show is coming up in a few weeks, and you should see some of that there. But the old down payment of the zeros and the 10%, I think that's going to be, you know, a little bit fewer and far between. Again, I guess I'm going to say, if you have qualified income, you can prove it, you have good credit, there is not an issue at all. Things are almost as usual. I guess when I say as usual, I'm going to stop myself a little bit there, because we've had a little bit of an issue in the industry regarding fraud. So we've had some identity theft come up. We've had some fraudulent boats come up. So the banks, us, a service company, any lender is truly going to dive deeper into a deal now.
Right.
So, you know, we're going to ask for tax returns where we may have not asked for tax returns before. We're going to want proof of income other than the tax return. So we may want to see a W-2, or we will want to see the last two pay stubs for sure. We'll want to see utility bills. We will want to see possibly bank statements. On the boat itself, you know, we're going to want to see clear title. So if you're buying a used boat, you know, we need to see that it's coming from the seller that had the boat prior to you. So we need to have physical title in hand. For new boats, we are going to be calling manufacturers to find out, you know, is this boat, did you sell this boat to this dealership, and does it exist? So we've had a few fraudulent MSOs come our way and come through the industry on even big boats, so Sea Rays and Vikings. And the identity theft there has been very, very good. Fake dealerships, fake MSOs, fake tax returns, the whole boat. So from a lending perspective, for everybody to stay protective, they're going to ask for hull rubbings or pictures of your hull identification number. They're going to ask for an inspection or a survey. And a survey, the only thing that's going to do is help you out. So, you know, it'll point out some ideas that you may have not been looking for. You know, some, I don't know, give me some examples there. What's a survey going to help you out at?
Well, not only from a cosmetic standpoint, but it's going to include a sea trial. Sometimes you may want to order an additional engine survey, oil analysis. You know, if it's a sailboat, they're going to check all the rigging. So it's very important that a surveyor or an inspection company, you know, goes through the boat and tests all of the equipment, including the engines, to make sure that it's a seaworthy boat. And you'd be surprised how many things come up that are not really a big deal, but certainly that a seller can take care of or can give a survey-adjusted price to accommodate you for those items.
So, I mean, things like blistering, items like a stringer has come detached from the hull. I mean, there's things that you may not look for that, you know, a surveyor is an expert. You know, that's where they excel. So let them help you out and pay the extra, you know, $500, $700. I mean, it depends on the size of the boat on how much the survey is going to cost.
Right.
But it's well worth the price. That being said, is there anything else you want to cover today?
I'm good for today. We have the boat show coming up. The boat show starts October 30th and runs through November 3rd here in Fort Lauderdale. We will have two booths at the show, one in the convention center. I believe it's booth 4010. And we also have a booth at Bahia Mar at the Yachting Center, and that is booth 1612. So we'd Jack and I'll both be there.
Very good. I'm surprised that I wouldn't have remembered those numbers. So very, very good. So have a good boat show. Please give us a call at 877-435-3633 with any questions you may have, or visit us at eBoatLoans.com. Thanks and have a great day.
See you, everyone. Bye-bye.